Many public and private agencies. The current pandemic was just not health issues, but also social, economic, and religious crisis. The social workers and NGOs practiced the virtue of humility just like Mother Mary by rushing to the places that require help, care, and support. Let us practice in our daily life to reach out to others who require our help, care, and support. Let us make Mother Mary model of our lives and follow her footsteps.
28th March 2020. Everything was different. Life was getting rough. All felt helpless. There are people who do not have the basic necessity for their survival. And this pandemic has made it more difficult. The lockdown announced by Prime Minister, and people wait on the streets with the packed bags of their personal belongings, carrying them on their heads, and walk in groups due to lack of transportation. People who are COVID positive are home quarantined, and there is a challenge of getting cooked food. Due to the rules set by a disaster management, the restaurants and shops are closed.
Social workers are essential for more than a century. Members of the social work profession have been dedicated to helping individuals, families, communities, and our society to reach to their full potential. Social workers, amidst the helplessness of an individual, have reached out to the ones in need around them.
Thank you. Gabriel appeared and informed Mary that her relative Elizabeth in her old age has also conceived a son, and Elizabeth is in the sixth month. In those days, Mary set out and went with haste.
Take care. God bless you.
Bye. Have a safe journey.
To a Judean town in the hill country to meet Elizabeth.
Mary knocks at the house of Zachariah.
Greetings, Zachariah.
I'm Mary, Joachim's daughter. How are you? We haven't seen each other for years now.
Greetings.
My brother has lost speech. It has been over 6 months. One day he entered the temple and came back out mute. Who knows what he saw?
And Elizabeth?
Elizabeth.
Greetings, Elizabeth.
Mary, may you be blessed amongst all women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And why has this happened to me? That the mother of my Lord comes to me. For as soon as I heard the sound of your greetings, the baby in my womb leaped for joy. And blessed is she who believed that there would be a fulfillment of what was spoken to her by the Lord.
Let us reflect. Over the last year, we have been witness to people seeking help in places which are out of our reach. During this time, social workers, NGOs played a crucial part in reaching out to the needy. These social workers, NGOs faced lots of challenges as they had limited people, limited transportation, permission to travel, official clearances and formalities. The list is endless. But they did not give up or stop. Instead, they continued their mission to help the needy. Mama Mary too reached out to her cousin Elizabeth, who was in her old age and in her 6 months of pregnancy. Her source of message was through the angel Gabriel. She decided to not just stay in her current situation, but she chose to act upon the message and journeyed to visit and help her cousin Elizabeth. Her journey was not easy, yet she did not give up.
Just like Mary, you and I are called to be the arms of the church by reaching out to the people. By doing this, we are strengthening and practicing our faith, that is, reaching out to our neighbors. Mama Mary is calling you by name. Listen to her as she says, "Are you willing to take that one step of moving out and reaching to people in need? Or do we wait for others to take the lead?" Mama Mary is not asking us to do big things, but just as we have seen the social workers doing it, she calls us to be an instrument of comfort, solace, and joy. We can reach out to people in small or little ways by giving ration, spending time with the lonely, counsel the ones who have lost their dear ones, or impart our knowledge by teaching children, or cook food, or provide grocery, or empower people, and the list is endless. To start, we can begin as an individual by joining the church associations like SVP, Legion of Mary, Youth, or Women's Cell. To be a social worker is a call to work in the Lord's vineyard. As rightly said by Saint Mother Teresa, helping hands are better than praying lips.
Whatsoever you do to the least of my people, that you do unto me. When I was hungry, you gave me to eat. When I was thirsty, you gave me to drink. Now enter into the home of my Father. Whatsoever you do to the least of my people, that you do unto me.
Let us recite the novena prayer together. O most holy Virgin, you were chosen to be the mother of Jesus. Permit me, your devoted client, to praise you for this unique privilege. O tender mother and comfortress of the afflicted, grant me the special protection which you have promised to those who venerate you. Relying on the infinite mercies of your divine Son, trusting on his promises that those who ask would receive, and penetrated with confidence in your powerful intercession, I most humbly entreat you to obtain for me the favors which I petition for in this novena, if it is the holy will of God, or else whatever graces I most stand in need of. Kindly place your request. In veneration of the love and joy with which your heart was replenished when the Word was made flesh in your womb, I offer you the sentiments of my heart. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
O Mother of God, accept these salutations in union with the veneration with which the angel Gabriel first hailed you, full of grace. I wish most sincerely that these may become so many gems in the crown of your celestial glory. Mother Mary, to your keeping, soul and body we confine, toiling, resting, walking, sleeping, be you ever at our side. Cares that vexes, joys that pleases, life and death, we trust in you. You make yours all for Jesus and for all eternity. Amen.
Good morning to all of you and a warm welcome for this Eucharistic celebration. Today's novena theme is we are remembering and praying in a very special way for social workers. Today's Mass intentions for the departed soul of John DiCona, birthday of Agnes Lobo, soul of John D'Souza, to Our Lady for the good health of Alwin Lobo, to Divine Mercy for good health of Lobo and family, soul of Mabel Mascarenhas, soul of Catherine Alfonso, soul of Cosenzao and Peter Lobo, soul of Alvin Fernandez, soul of Regina Quadros, soul of Pascal and Magdalene Rodriguez, soul of Leonilda and Anthony, soul of D'Souza and Gonsalves family, soul of Gregory Pinto, soul of Francis Almeida, soul of Filomena Lobo, soul of Benny Pinto, to Our Lady for the good health and peace in family, soul of Walty Menezes, soul of Newton Azevedo, soul of Silvia Fernandez, soul of D'Souza and Gonsalves family, soul of Irene Jonas, soul of Lenny Lobo, soul of Joaquim Santos, soul of Maria Vaz, soul of Alec Vaz, soul of Teresa Vaz, soul of all the departed souls, and Mass offered to Our Lady for Daisy and Ivan Lopez. Let's also put our own personal prayers intentions. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves for these sacred mysteries, let us call to our mind our shortcomings and our failures, for those moments that we have failed to reach out, for those moments we could have done something in our life, we hesitated or we have withdrawn ourselves to reaching out, to helping out people. For all those moments, let's ask God's pardon and mercy. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Pardon the faults of your servants, we pray, O Lord, that we who cannot please you by our own deeds may be served through the intercession of the mother of your Son and our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
First reading. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Paul, an apostle of Christ Jesus by the will of God, and Timothy, our brother, to the saints and faithful brothers in Christ at Colossae. Grace to you and peace from God our Father. We always thank God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, when we pray for you. Since we heard of your faith in Christ Jesus and of the love that you have for all the saints, because of the hope laid up for you in heaven. Of this you have heard before in the word of the truth, the gospel which has come to you, as indeed in the whole world it is bearing fruit and increasing, as it also does among you. Since the day you heard it, and understood the grace of God in truth, just as you learned it from Epaphras, our beloved fellow servant. He is a faithful minister of Christ on your behalf and has made known to us your love in the Spirit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The responsorial psalm. Your response shall be, I trust in the mercy of God forever and ever. Repeat.
I trust in the mercy of God forever and ever.
I am like a growing olive tree in the house of God. I trust in the mercy of God forever and ever. Response:
I trust in the mercy of God forever and ever.
I will thank you forevermore, for this is your doing. I will hope in your name, for it is good in the presence of your faithful. Your response,
I trust in the mercy of God forever and ever.
Kindly rise for the gospel.
Of eternity.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
In those days, Mary arose and went with haste into the hill country to a town in Judah. And she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. And when Elizabeth heard the greetings of Mary, the baby leaped in her womb. And Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit. She exclaimed with a loud cry, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And why is this granted to me, that the mother of my Lord should come to me? For behold, when the sound of your greeting came to my ears, the baby in my womb leaped for joy. And blessed is she who believed that there would be a fulfillment of what was spoken to her from the Lord." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, three men entered a church and they began to pray. The first one was a family man. So he knelt down and said to the Lord, "Lord, bless me and bless my wife and bless my son and bless his wife. Us four and no one." The second man who entered was a couple, childless couple. He knelt down and he prayed, "Lord, bless us too, all that we do." And the third gentleman who also entered and was praying was an old bachelor man, was not married, single, and he prayed this way, "Lord, bless only me, and that's as far as I can see." My dear brothers and sisters, through this prayer of these three people who entered the church and began to pray, gives us an impression, makes us to believe or understand that there are some people that they can see as far as their nose goes, not beyond that. It's always me, or I. And that is all they think and nothing else. And so the biggest problem that we face in today's world, my dear brothers and sisters, is that there is so much of selfishness and self-centeredness. People like to think only about themselves, only about their family, about their partner, about their children, and they are not worried or concerned about the other. The theme and the gospel reminds us and invites us rather to think of the other, not so much of ourselves. The gospel that we read clearly specifies or clearly shows us that Mother Mary leaves her hometown, her house, her whoever, near dear ones, and she rushes. She goes out to reach out to her cousin Elizabeth, who was in difficulty, who was in trouble probably, who needed support and help. She leaves everything and runs. Hurriedly she goes because she knows this woman Elizabeth needs more attention, needs more care, needs more support, needs more helping hand. She doesn't bother about anything. The road, how it will be, what would be the condition, whether there will be bandits or thieves, robbers, thorny wild animals, she doesn't think of anything. Her whole focus is to reach and help Elizabeth. And that's why the scripture mentions, hurriedly she went because she knew the urgency and the need of the hour. And that's what we remember today. All the social workers during this pandemic
had been a great job that they have done. They have left their family, they didn't bother about themselves, they didn't care about themselves. We went out to reach to various people, whether it is providing food, whether it is providing maybe a ration, whether it is providing a support, or whether reaching them out to do some that they can, something that they can feel comfortable and ease and live a good life. And that's what the reading and this novena of today, my dear brothers and sisters, invites us first of all to pray for all those people who have risked their own life. Not only the NGOs, when we talk about social work, we only think of NGOs, not only NGOs, yes, but there are also individual people from their own part have done something, may not be gone far away to various places, but their own neighborhood, in their own buildings, they have reached out to these people. And so we like to appreciate these people today and like to pray for these people that God may bless them for their generosity, for their altruistic attitude that they had, just as Mother Mary had. Mother Mary, we see, we reach out not only to Elizabeth. When she gets news about Jesus, some say that he is gone off, he is not doing well. Mother Mary is immediately rushed to where Jesus is, and his disciples tell, your mother and your sister is waiting out. And he says, who are my mother? So hearing the news about Jesus, what he is doing, she goes to bring him home probably. We also hear when Jesus was lost, she runs back immediately to search for Jesus. The wedding feast at Cana, she sees the situation not that good. She immediately runs to her son to ask to do something. And so we see that she always reaches out to others, and she invites her children, to each one of us today, to reach out in our own way. May not be in monetary, or may not be something to give, but also maybe just a visit to the sick, maybe a phone call to someone who is maybe upset or maybe not having a good day, cheering up. These are all social work that we can do by reaching out to one another. And so during this Holy Eucharist, my dear brothers and sisters, let us ask the Lord to give us that grace and strength that we may not be an individualistic, but that we will be altruistic, that we will be reaching out and doing whatever in our will, with whatever in our power, whatever we can do to the least of our brothers and sisters. Please stand for prayers of the faithful. Dear brothers and sisters, Mary, who followed the will of God by saying yes to him, like Mary, we too are invited to say a total yes to his divine call and to be faithful to our ministry of reaching out to the people in need. Let our response be, through the intercession of Mother Mary, Lord, hear our prayer.
Through the intercession of Mother Mary, Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our Holy Father, Pope Francis, bishops, priests, and all the religious, that their deep intimacy with the Lord help them to be faithful to their call. May all the committed leaders of the Church be deeply rooted in God, and may God be their constant companion in all the events of their life. For this, we pray to the Lord.
Through the intercession of Mother Mary, Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the people who comfort the poor, the downtrodden, and those suffering, especially the social workers, that their services and charitable works be rewarded by God. Grant them wisdom and help them to see Christ in people they encounter. For this, we pray to the Lord.
Through the intercession of Mother Mary, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, we pray for the whole human family, which is in turmoil and burdened with fear of coronavirus. Protect our families and friends from being infected by this deadly virus. Give us your spirit of love and self-discipline so that we may come together working to control and eliminate the coronavirus. For this, we pray to the Lord.
Through the intercession of Mother Mary, Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray for everyone participating in this Holy Eucharist and for their various intentions, that their desires may be fulfilled according to the plan of God. And may God grant them all the necessary graces and blessings. For this, we pray to the Lord.
Through the intercession of Mother Mary, Lord, hear our prayer. Let us pause and pray for all our personal and community needs. For this, we pray to the Lord. Through the intercession of Mother Mary, Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, we thank you for the gift of Mother Mary, who is our model in living Christ's redemptive work. Give us the grace to be prominent sign of God's mission and love. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Priests, sisters and brothers, let our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Accept, O Lord, the offerings we bring you, and grant that enlightened by the Holy Spirit and encouraged by the example of Blessed Virgin Mary, our hearts may always seek out and treasure the things that are yours. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, and to praise, bless and glorify your name of the Blessed Ever Virgin Mary. For by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, she conceived your only begotten Son, and without losing the glory of virginity, brought forth into the world the eternal life, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exultation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread. And giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Savior of the world.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, also gracious, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, with the blessed apostles, Saint Vincent Paluti, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coheirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
As we call on to God, our loving Father, let us place all our prayers and intentions. Let's remember all the social workers, organizations, NGOs, individuals, and all our parishioners. And the Lord may bless all of us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other a sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
O Lord Jesus, since I cannot receive you in your sacramental presence, I beg you to come spiritually into my soul to enrich me with your holy grace and make me truly your own forever. O Jesus, living in Mary, come and live in me, in the spirit of your holiness, in the fullness of your power, in the communion of your mysteries, in the perfection of your ways. O divine guest, give to my soul a strong, lively faith, an unbounded trust, perfect humility, an abiding sorrow for my sins, a total abandonment to your divine will, and a perfect loving union with you in mind and heart. O Sacrament Most Holy, O Sacrament Divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. Lord Jesus, thank you for the blessings and graces you have given me through this spiritual communion.
His love will still remain.
Let us pray. Having received the sacrament of salvation of faith, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, that we who devoutly honor the Blessed Virgin Mary may be worthy to share with her in the charity of heaven through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I'd like to thank today's liturgy that is being prepared by Standard 1, 5th and 6th of our Sunday school. The catechist who helped them to prepare this novena, Aida, Sister Ankita, Shalini and Yvonne. I'd like to thank all of them. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go out to love and to serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Stay.